Howdy folks, and welcome to another episode of World of Warships. With me, Cowtoface. So today's episode of World of Warships is actually with an aircraft carrier. Yeah, I know we are getting a few of those. But, well, Sniper is in command of this Hakuryu. I don't know, I have no idea how to pronounce it. How does the Japanese think it's a good idea to put a K-U-R-Y-U after each other? How are you gonna pronounce that? I mean, well, back to the game. So Sniper's team has split up. Most of the team is heading down to Alpha, which is a some of the team is I don't know if they are undecided where to go. Some of them is somewhat heading up to Charlie, but are maybe coming back. Two of them are two battleships. So they may be slow, I don't know. They are hanging around the middle. And well, Sniper is, you know, where aircraft carriers tends to be, in the back, sending the strike packages out. But this aircraft carrier is another one of Wargaming's paper designs. Or yeah, I think it's a paper design. In Japanese it means white dragon, which is pretty cool. And sorry about that, I was just about to die. It is based off a project G15 Taiho Kai, something like that. And it was an attempt by the Japanese designers to create a successor to the somewhat flawed Taiho class aircraft carrier. And she was to be larger, better armed, better protected, carry a larger aircrew, and would have corrected the many flaws found in her predecessor's design. And as we can see, so far Sniper is making good use of the larger aircrew, and that dive bomber hit just right. I know it is possible to, you know, hit the weak armor deck on a ship and still get a citadel, but I know from my experience on the receiving end of a dive bomber, it doesn't feel like it happens too often. But then again, so far it has been going pretty well for Sniper, all things considered. He has lost roughly half of his hit points, but he's still alive and he's about to go behind an island, so he will have some cover, at least. And, Sniper's carrier was not gonna be alone there was 7 of this class planned to be laid down between 44 and 45. Which is ambitious when you look at how the war was going at that time. Basically from 43 it has been going backwards for the Japanese. And it was planned to be down in 45-44ish, with an expected completion date between 47 and 48. I mean, Japan is getting bombed to hell. The US is rebuilding their fleet with new and modern battleships, and not just, you know, modernizing battleships, and not just semi-modern, pre-war, 30s area battleships. No, no. This is wartime battleships, like Iowa. And they have the carriers of Midway, and I mean, by 47, 48, come on, guys. However, the project was suspended after the Battle of Midway, surprise, in order to focus on construction, in order to focus construction efforts on the smaller smaller carrier class, before finally being cancelled in August of 43, so yeah. And in order to concentrate on development of a smaller, less expensive G18 class. And the name of the carrier, this Hakuryu, yeah, was given to the class by Wargaming in accordance to the Imperial Japanese tradition of to name aircraft carriers after birds or mythological creatures. So, there is a fair chance that the class might have been called this in real life had it ever been built. And well, it is Wargaming, it is a computer game, so there is gonna be some historical inaccuracies. And we will get to them a bit later, because so far Sniper's team has, well, they have one control over Alpha, which wasn't that hard, because most of the enemy team went to Bravo and Charlie. But now Sniper's team is making their way in mass to Bravo, and is well, they just completed it, they just got the point. And Sniper is making the well, he's hitting the weak spot on this Yamato, because he's getting 3 citadels and a shit ton of damage. But even with the game so far in turning to this team's favor, they are still 300 points behind, one kill down compared to the enemy team. But at least so far, if they can at least keep the momentum, they will have a fair chance to push the enemy back, because well, they still have those ships who I think have run all the range from Charlie on the right flank. They have, well, 90% of their team in the center, and they can use the Sniper's aircraft carrier to control the left flank. So, well, basically, they are in a fairly good position. The enemy team has taken the lead. Also, because most of the enemy team is caught in the open. So, they don't have any place to hide. Whereas Sniper's team, well, they're still behind island cover, so if they can use the island's cover pretty well, well, they have a good chance to deal some good blows to the enemy team while taking minimal damage. And here we just see Sniper doing some typical aircraft carrier behavior that I have never quite understood. You know, aircraft carrier players, they are a weird collection. You don't really know where you have them. But this is gonna be a nice hit. Guaranteed at least 2 torpedo hits, because this Yamato was going backwards. Sadly, he doesn't get the kill, because the Conqueror, did manage to, either land the shell. Well, he did get two torpedo hits, so he wouldn't have killed him anyway. But he couldn't have had much health left. But the enemy team are bleeding ships. But Sniper is in somewhat trouble right now. Mostly because he can't hit this destroyer. Sorry, I'm just about to die again. But, well, he has trouble hitting this destroyer. So, but then again, the destroyer might get some torpedoes off. Sniper might eat a few, but he does still have health enough left that he can at least take a few torpedoes without being too much worried about the consequences. But well, he did, you know, third time the jump. He did end up getting the kill, so just short of 100,000 damage. And one kill. Talk about spreading the damage. Approaching target. Then again, he has been spotting pretty well because he has done 100,000 damage by himself. But he has spotted for 115,000 damage. So he has done pretty well, I will say. And the team are still behind on points, but now it's only 30-ish. And they are ahead of on kills. So, if they can get one more kill, they are gonna be in the lead. Well, they just lost the Kremlin. So, there is that. The enemy team still has the chance to pull this off. There's only 5 minutes left of the game. Equal team. They are 150-ish points ahead. Not a citadel for a dive bomber, but it's pretty good. But the enemy team still has the chance to win this. Because, two of the sniper's team are pretty isolated. Up north, to the left, right, to the right, in the left. God damn it, cow, go to bed. There we go, they managed to get the Conqueror. So they have at least gained those points they lost by the Kremlin. But the enemy team are still ahead on points. And those two ships are still pretty isolated. We're under attack. Then again, that battleship does seem like he has pulled a Nutzer. He does seem to be pretty stationary. So if we can get some good torpedo hits on him, well, we might end up getting a second kill. And while Sniper is trying to get the second kill, maybe we should take those historical inaccuracies. One of them I have sort of told you already. No ship in the Imperial Japanese Navy. Cool name. Was ever named the name of this carrier. I'm not gonna pronounce that again. And the production of the Japanese 40mm Bofors began in late 44. And of course, this carrier was cancelled in 43. But then again, you know, had this ship been completed, there is a good chance that it would have received the Bofors. So it's more a what if inaccuracy. And the Japanese version of the 40mm Bofors had a defective fuse design, which limited it its effective range to 3 kilometers. Yeah. You know, when you have a good group of aircrafts, enemy aircrafts coming towards you, and you can only begin to shoot them down at roughly 3 kilometers. Yeah, those 3 kilometers go pretty damn fast when you fly roughly 400, 500 kilometers an hour. It's minutes we are talking about here. Seconds. Those 3 kilometers are gonna be whoosh. But well, that is well, some of the inaccuracies of this carrier in the game. Even though one of them is more a what if inaccuracy, you know, when the ship got cancelled in 43, and the guns began production in 44. Is it really then an inaccuracy? But then again, it is wargaming. It is not because they are known for their historical accuracies. Just look at the Russian battleships. But well, Sniper's team has managed to pull this one. Less than a minute left, they are 15 points away from winning. But that is at 2,100 XP, 160,000 damage roughly, and 4 on the team, pretty good. And we do have some details here for people who might like that. And he even managed to make a nice profit without the premium, so thumbs up for that. But with that, that's it folks. See you next time, and remember, it's Monday.